analyzing my every touch. Fuck. Oh, shit.
In the hope.
Awesome.
That I get that. Welcome to the new year, everyone. I'm back. So, for a bit of context on the series, all the games you've seen so far were from my fall season back in 2022. So, a little behind. Since then, I played two more seasons, and here are all my goals and contributions from season two.
Could've been a wonder, taking your circus to the sky. You couldn't take it on the tightrope.
Quick side note, you might be wondering why this was shot on a CCTV camera, but the reason is this. Yeah, thanks, Drew. You're not going to be invited to my birthday party.
Yep, that's right. After a whole entire season, I ended up with one goal and three assists. For reference, last season, I scored three goals and made one assist. So, I've gotten worse? Awesome. All good though, because here was my opportunity to tie the game in the final minutes of a semi-final playoff game. Whoops. Sure fucked that up. Yeah, so that would have made up for everything. I do have this, though.
Yes! Oh my god!
Now that we're all caught up, I'll be uploading my best games from this past fall season, and then this upcoming March, I'll be playing yet again. The pain will never end. Alright, now with all that yapping done, on to the first episode of season 3. First touch of the game. I'm drop deep, receive the ball, and turn out. I recognize that I'm not under a lot of pressure.
Cosman talk about pressure. I don't feel pressure.
So I take the time to get my head up and pass to my midfielder, John, who casually destroys number 16's entire family lineage and runs up the field before playing the ball back to me. I begin running down the line until finally trying to cross the ball across the 6-yard box, only for it to be cleared by one of their defenders. Ultimately, not a bad play. I was going for the early ball that curves behind the back line, seeking my forward, which is one of the most dangerous balls in football, as it is difficult for defenders since they are running toward their own goal, forcing them to risk taking a touch and scoring an own goal, or letting it go and having the forward pounce. When the curl is done right, it can also land right at the feet of the forward while evading the retreating defenders. I unfortunately only have theory on my side, because my execution caused this cross to be as dangerous as Richarlison.
I'm a Spurs fan, by the way.
For this cross to have been successful, I had to release it earlier and with a lot more pace. To make it easier for me to reach Marco, instead of just running alongside the ball for half an hour, I could have taken a couple touches inside, getting me closer to the goal and reducing the length the ball would have to travel. Next touch. The ball pops out to me and I let it run. I eventually bring it down and then wait until my mid Matthias runs in behind and send in a decent through ball into his path. Unfortunately, nothing really materializes from this, but it was a good play. Now, if I was actually good, I would have seen this pass right here to Marco. It would have been completely one-on-one with the goalie. But honestly, I'm just glad I see anything at all. So I'm happy with this. Maybe in 2025. Ladies and gentlemen, a throw-in. Let's see if after an entire year, I've gotten any better at these. I receive the ball, I shield it, and just play it back. Ah, progress. You know what? Even though I look like a cartoon character, this was decent. Next play. Marco sends a great ball out to me, sending me straight into a 1v1 with the keeper, but I unfortunately trip and fall over. No way, bitch, I fucking score. Oh shit! I'm good at the sport. Jokes aside, this was a great play. I made a good run in between the lines, took the ball at the perfect time, and just casually passed it right past the keeper, making it 1-0. By far my greatest start to a season ever. Uh-oh, that can't be good. Next play, Matthias sends a great through ball to Marco, who's through on goal. He takes a touch out wide to beat his defender and then hits a great strike into the bottom right corner, making it 2-0. Folks, what the fuck is going on?
Side note, you can tell that none of us are used to this because even though this clearly goes in, when you listen to our reaction, you can instantly see us gaslighting ourselves into thinking that this was the side netting or something. Okay, moving on. Matthias gets a quick bonk, which pops out to Marco. He brings it down, spots me out wide. I take a 300-pound touch toward goal, but make it just in time to chip the keeper and make it 3-0. Huh? I've already scored more goals in my first 30 minutes of this season than I did my entire last season. In math, we call that exponential growth, bitch. Now, despite already grabbing a brace, it was refreshing to see that the old me was still in there when a simple touch turned into a 30-meter dash. But it did draw the keeper out, so maybe it was all planned.
Science rules.
Kind of like how my birth was definitely planned. All right, next touch. Let's finally return to my brand and just watch me ping a ball straight into a guy's foot. Good to feel like myself again. I would also like to highlight my tenacity to try and win this ball back.
Marco.
I especially want to point out how right here, I kind of look like a big toddler, frantically looking for his mother in the grocery store. Also, I didn't have any options at all, so this was literally the only thing I could have done. So, good job, me. Now let's move on to this play, where John sends me down the line, and I run like you would in your nightmares when you're being chased by a murderer. Except this transforms from a nightmare into a dream, because I end up getting to this ball and keep it in. But then we go back into a nightmare, as the referees never watched the Japan-Germany game and claim this went out. Moments like these really make you ponder, why was VAR not set up for this 30th tier Sunday League game? Next touch. Ball is played out to their back line. I get in front of their right back to win it and play it out wide to the sideline. Oh, so just pass it to a teammate next time? Got it. Always learning. All right, ball comes out to me and...
Nice.
What am I doing? I've been watching too many Antony highlights, I guess. Just pass it to any of these guys and move on. Here, we have Malibu building up a nice attack. They play it out to their winger, who sends in a dangerous ball, but who is there but Mickey van de Ven himself, with the electric pace to clear this ball just in time. What can I say? Defense, offense, it's all the same to me. Moving on, I receive the ball from a throw-in with tons of time and space. I look at this daunting amount of space in front of me and think, no thanks. That's for someone with some confidence, and just play it out wide. Ultimately, nothing necessarily wrong with this play. We kept possession, and I was able to reposition to help the attack, but when you're given this much space, you gotta try and exploit it. Here, the ball is lost in their third, and I get to the loose ball. I pass it out to Drew, and we unfortunately end up losing possession. A simple play, but I want to look at a couple things here. Number one, I once again do not exploit the space. As you can see, there's an opening right here, with the right back being drawn out wide to cover Drew's run, opening up a clear lane to goal. Alternatively, once I do play this out to Drew, let's take a look at my off-the-ball movement. Once I release this, I just jog alongside their defender and run toward Drew, a completely useless position. Instead, the second I release this, I should be running straight toward the gap I just mentioned, creating a nice passing lane for Drew to play back to me, and I would be well on my merry way to maybe get a hat trick. Now, while we are comfortably up 3-0, Malibu decided they are not out of the game yet and start building. They split our defense with two great passes and start moving down the wing, eventually playing a great early ball across the face of goal and pulling one back. His ball was a lot better than mine. Next touch. The ball ping-pongs around for a little until eventually coming out to me. I try to turn, but am instantly dispossessed. This is a classic case of me forcing the use of my dominant foot. To escape this pressure, I need to take my touch out here, which would be easier to do with my right. Next play, the ball is played out to me wide by our forward Ben, and I take my touch with my right foot, which is awesome. Except here, it actually would have been better to take it with my left. Why am I like this? I don't know. In general, it's always best to take your touch with your back foot. Anyway, I end up taking this all the way to the line for some reason, and then once again just run alongside it while I ponder what to do with it. And then I just decide to blast it in the box while no one is there. Awesome. This is almost an identical play to earlier, mimicking each mistake
almost to a T. It seems that unfortunately, I do not possess a short-term memory. Here, Lyndon switches the play over to me. I take a good first touch to bring it down and then hit a beautiful Travel pass to get it to Matthias, but unfortunately, nothing quite develops. I low-key ate here and felt a bit like mother. Anyway, halftime is called and I hit the camera with a cheeky little snoozer emote. Boring. What a quirky little guy. And then I'm instantly hit with karma as within minutes of kickoff, Malibu end up scoring another. All good. Still 3-2. I'm not worried. This will be fine. Nothing bad happens at the end of this video. Keep watching. Ball comes out to me on the wing. I'm not under pressure or anything, so I just kind of vibe out for a bit. I then look up and see Matthias, so I try and play a ball to him, but it's instantly intercepted. Great decision making here. Now, to be fair, when I look up here, there are really no great options. Nobody's really checking into any good spots, and our midfield is completely abandoned. What also does end up helping my case a little bit here is that Matthias gives me mixed signals, much like most of the women in my life have, and says, "Yes, Dave, please, I want you to give it to me," and then runs off with another guy. Ultimately, if you don't see any options, just turn it around and give it to your back line so they can work a switch. Next, I intercept the ball in the wing, causing the ball to pop up. I end up bringing it down, although very unconvincingly, and then cut it back and play it out to Matthias. Ultimately, this was fine. I think it would have been cool if I was a bit nicer with it and took this touch down the line to try and build an attack. But this is better than just missing the ball entirely, which is what I usually do. Speaking of how I usually do, I'm just gonna let the next bit play out.
Nice work. Stay on, Lynn.
Oh, no.
To all the TikTok comments asking if this is the special needs league, you might be onto something. Next play. John plays a nice weighted ball out to me on the wing. I take a touch down the line and then try to once again cross it into the box, but it once again gets blocked by one of their defenders. Again, I needed to get my head up early, because had I done that, I would have seen Lyndon, who is completely on his own near the back post. Rather than take this touch, I should have tried to lob a high ball first time over to him, leaving him alone with the keeper. Next up, we got us losing possession in a dangerous area. They play the ball across our 6-yard box, and we end up conceding the weirdest penalty I have ever seen. Anyway, the penalty is taken, and Derek with a great save, and oh, they score on the rebound. Well, that's disappointing. All good, though. It's still just 3-3, and we move on. They begin driving it down the middle, play the ball out wide. He takes a great strike, but Derek is back to the rescue. They score off the rebound again. Coming back from a 3-0 deficit to a 4-3 lead. This aged really well. With the momentum in their favor, things looked grim. The ball is played out wide to Lyndon, who cuts in, and Kirk ends up taking possession, playing the ball out to me in the middle. I fake a touch inside, but play it off with the outside of my foot to John, who takes a touch inside and places it into the far corner, equalizing the game at 4-4. What a roller coaster. And an assist to add to my repertoire. This was a great pass, and a very important moment for the game. Now, despite the ups and downs of this game, I do not give up. Never. And this sequence is a perfect example of my spirit. Their number 6 tries to turn me out, but forgets that I am slippery, like a slippery snake, and slide to kick the ball to our back line. Ross ends up playing it back out to me, and I bring it down with my chest and try to shield the ball. Their defender is able to stick a foot out, and I try to escape the pressure, but he ends up overpowering me, but on my way down, I stick a foot out and send the ball out wide. It gets intercepted by their winger, but I get back up and am able to once again get a foot out and intercept, until eventually being fouled and brought down. This must have been exactly how the soldiers felt storming the beaches of Normandy. I'll be surprised if this clip does not get flagged for copyright, since it's so identical to Saving Private Ryan. Moving on. Ben runs down the line and cuts the ball back to me on the edge of the box. It's the final minutes of the game. The ball is played a bit behind me, so I have to adjust with a quick touch, and I play the ball back to Ben, who ends up being called offside. So I probably should have done more with this. I either should have taken a touch right in front of me and just instantly tried to have a shot, or turned with this, since it was a bit behind me, and tried to feed this off to Marco. Definitely wasn't the easiest opportunity, but certainly should have ended with something better than an offside. And that's the end of the game. We tied 4-4, and despite starting the season with 2 goals and an assist, I still felt like shit. Football.
the beautiful game. Thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next one. And as always, let's get better together.